Of course, when you're going through an IVF cycle, you'll be given hormones in order to stimulate the ovaries. So the question is, do these hormones make you crazy? My name's Dr. Joseph Sgroi. I'm an obstetrician, gynecologist, and fertility specialist with Melbourne IVF. Now, during every menstrual cycle, a woman will produce hormones, predominantly estrogen in the first part of her cycle and then progesterone in the last part of her cycle. And some women already know that during their menstrual cycle, they may have an element of dysphoria or some mood symptoms towards the latter part of their cycles. And it's very common, around 15 to 20% of women will have an element of dysphoria or premenstrual tension. And of course, doing any IVF treatment will increase the hormones within your body. So potentially there is a risk, of course, that it might heighten those symptoms. Now, I'm reminded of a time when, for those of you who can remember, the mini-series or the series Offspring. And I was very fortunate during the series of Offspring to be one of their medical advisors. And for those of you very familiar with the character, Nina Proudman went through fertility treatment herself. And I was the medical advisor at the time that she was actually doing her IVF treatment, providing advice to the script writers. And in one of those episodes, they talked about the fact that the medication would make her mad and crazy. But I can assure you, it doesn't make you mad and crazy. Whilst most women will sail through all fertility treatment quite easily, in actual fact, when you commence your hormone treatment on day 3 of your cycle, you'll have a hormone known as follicle stimulating hormone. And what this does is it increases the follicles or the size of the follicles within the ovary. And as a result of this, there's an increase in the amount of estrogen. Of course, this is more estrogen than you would normally have in any ordinary menstrual cycle because there's gonna be larger follicles. Rather than there be just one follicle producing estrogen, there'll be multiple follicles producing estrogen. So if you're susceptible to headaches during the first part of your menstrual cycle, you might find that you actually get an additional amount of headaches, particularly in that first part of the cycle. Now, the other thing that women may experience as the ovaries start growing under the influence of the hormones and the follicles start growing is some abdominal bloating, also some nausea, and in some cases, some light vomiting. But of course, this is very rare. Most women indeed are actually going through their IVF cycles while still at work. And here at Melbourne IVF, given that we're all as fertility specialists as committed to you as we are to the process of fertility treatment, we undertake all our scans in the first part of your cycle early on in the morning, which means that most, if not all of you, can get to work on time. So being able to work through an IVF cycle seems almost unheard of, but in actual fact, every single woman who's ever done IVF over the course of those years has been able to continue working during their IVF cycles. Now, during the latter part of the cycle, of course, we switch from producing predominantly estrogen to progesterone. And during this period of time, the progesterone may cause you to have that additional bloating type symptoms. And in addition to that, also some women may complain of constipation. But of course, those women who do experience the dysphoria or that premenstrual tension might find that's a little bit heightened towards the latter part of the cycle of IVF. Now, of course, when we're doing IVF treatment, we are raising all those hormones that I talked to you about before, but we're actually not raising them much more than what you would have in pregnancy itself. In actual fact, pregnancy has a huge amount of hormones racing through the body. And that's why a lot of the symptoms that women may experience during their IVF treatment may also be symptoms they'll experience when they're pregnant, because there will be higher estrogen and progesterone levels when indeed you're pregnant. So the truth of the matter is that for the vast majority of women, IVF treatment has no impact on their mental state, has no impact on their ability to function day to day, and that has no ability to be able to go to work. It may heighten some symptoms that you normally would have during your menstrual cycle, including headaches, abdominal bloating, and premenstrual tension, and of course, an element of nausea and also vomiting in very, very few cases. I hope you enjoyed that video on IVF and whether the hormones will make you crazy. We've got heaps more topics on fertility. Please click subscribe to hear more. Alternatively, leave a comment in the comment section below. If you want to speak to any one of our fertility specialists, then please don't hesitate to make an appointment.